Welcome to another episode of Does This Podcast Suck? This is episode 58. Joining us as always, MT.
Hey there. Hi there. Ho there.
And Kyle.
No.
Kyle is not here.
Though you may hear his voice and hear him talk, apparently no.
Not even once.
Speaking of not even once, apparently Mighty No. 9 got delayed again.
That game is never coming out.
Not even once.
It's supposed to come out originally, what, April of last year?
I don't even... What was the original release date? I should find the Kickstarter page.
I know the first delay was to September, and then it got delayed to February, and then this delay.
I think it was February of last year. That's sad. I wonder if it still has the original date if you go to the Kickstarter.
The game was originally set to release in April of 2015.
Christ. They're a bit late.
Because they're too busy working on another game.
No, they're too busy working on a cartoon and 47 fucking versions. What they should have done.
And another game.
To, get the PC version working. And then get the other 14 ports, right? Because I think what they did was, their eyes are bigger than their stomach, right? They had these stretch goals. We're going to make it for, 93 different platforms. And then, somehow they thought that they would do that and it would still be on time and everything would work. Yeah, no.
Be on PS4, PS3, Xbox One, 360, Xbox, original Xbox, your toaster, your cell phone, PlayStation Vita, a deck of cards.
Your keyboard, your LCD screen. Your cat. Your cat can't play video games, MT.
Maybe your cat can't. But anyway, what's kind of dumb about this delay is for matchmaking issues. What even matchmaking is there going to be in this game? I don't even understand. It's a fucking single player game. Is it leaderboard things?
Speedruns and shit, I think.
Just fucking release the game and work on that shit in a month one patch, for crying out loud.
Online battle race mode.
Who fucking cares?
The last stretch goal that they hit is the thing holding everything up right now. I'm looking at the giant chart of fucking money raining from the sky, and that's the one.
It could have been out by now, but no.
And I have I got all fucking excited, and I own three fucking copies of this. So I got it for PC, PS4, and 3DS, I think. And I bought one for Anel and Vertigo. I bought this game 15 times, and I'm never going to fucking play it.
I still blame the other game that they decided to throw out before even finished the fucking first game.
That definitely didn't help things.
Which, that
that Red Ash Legends?
No. Oh, well, they didn't put it out. Have they even started?
The Kickstarter didn't quite make it, but then some an actual company funded it, so that means that one's probably more important.
That'll probably come out before fucking Mighty No. 9 does at this rate.
Concept is... Oh, yeah, that's right. They put that Kickstarter in, and then the funding got announced, and everyone pulled out. They're like, dude,
rightfully so.
Yeah.
And, I think it's a dirty fucking thing what they did, too. They did the same kind of thing, I don't know, with Shenmue.
They announced it up front, though. With this one, it was hey, look, we want to kickstart another game. Everybody's like, oh, okay.
Not quite up front. After the initial surge, it kind of trickled out. Not necessarily they hit it per se.
The Shenmue was like relatively transparent. This one was not even remotely.
Well, I mean, it is now. If you look at the stretch goals thing, it says funded by Fuse. And then, there's all these, if we hit our goal, you'll get a bunch of shit no one cares about. Yay. So I was like, okay, guys, the fuck are you doing? Plus, Concept is making that other one. The Castlevania guy is doing, which I suddenly forgot the name of. Bloodstained.
Bloodstained, yeah.
Are you sure that's thumbs up?
Yep.
They might be publishing it, maybe.
Sorry. Inti Creates is also the developer for Mighty No. 9.
I know that they are doing another game, though. I was pretty sure it wasn't that one.
Yeah. Concept is just like the name of the company that Inafune owns, I think.
Yeah.
Here it is. Inti Creates is the company that's developing it, and they're also the company doing Bloodstained.
Okay.
So, and I'm getting that. Someday. Yeah, it doesn't come out until March of next year.
I think those are the only two games I kickstarted.
Yeah, me too. The Red Ash thing, I was kind of curious, but I was like,
I considered.
Oh, the banjo one.
Ukulele.
I
can't
think of the name, but there we go. I gave them my money. What did I give my money to again? Yeah, that one looked fun too.
I thought about doing Money for Shenmue, but just never got around to doing it.
I mean, I could buy that when it comes out. I'm not like... That one was like, eh.
Yeah, well, for me, with Shenmue, it was like, oh, that's a game I think people should deserve to be able to play. I'll pitch in $5. Like, yeah, I'm not really super interested in it, but...
It was like, I'm not interested unless they release something so that I can play the first two. Like, otherwise, I don't care. Like, I don't want to play the third one. I've never played the first two.
Like the only video game I've kickstarted was Amplitude.
Mm.
I was okay with that.
And you actually got that game in a relatively short time.
Yeah, it didn't come out
on time.
The only hitch with that one was it was, you know, planned out before Rock Band 4, and Rock Band 4 came out first. Not much, like, it wasn't way sooner, but 2 months.
Oh, that's right. I got a physical copy of Bloodstained. Yeah. I wonder if anyone else is buying that game. Did you get it, MT?
I think so. I don't fucking remember anymore. It's so long ago now.
I know.
No, it's that's probably what I best hate about not to these. Remember. One day you'll wake up and just, surprise, you have a game.
Well, I'm pretty sure I do, because I think I remember getting email updates about the Kickstarter project at points.
Yeah, like a billion. That's the one thing I kind of don't like. I mean, it's cool that they keep me so up to date, but holy fuck. Some of these fucking developers, like, there was a fervor, just a fucking... billion goddamn emails when the thing started. Is that jackass from IGN sitting on a couch with them in this live stream? I know I'm in the middle of a sentence, but that
ooh,
fucking
shiny
guy I hate, Colin from IGN, I hate that guy.
What the shit is going on here?
I pledged $28 for Bloodstained.
Oh, you did the digital copy.
Digital copy, yeah.
Yeah, that's a good deal.
I think I did a similar thing for Mighty No. 9.
I like physical games if I can get them, you know? Like, I got a physical disc for Mighty No. 9. And I figured I'd just print off my own case if I really want one.
Yeah, $20 for Mighty No. 9.
I have a blank Blu-ray case. I can probably just throw it in there. So, yeah. Anyhow, yeah. The game, the little game that couldn't. Someday it'll release. I can't fucking... Is there an actual... release, or are they still just beating off their dicks about it? I don't think we even have a real date yet.
Just says spring 2016.
The fucking audacity.
Probably like June, I imagine.
And they made this announcement like 2 weeks before the game was set to release. Oh, by the way, everybody. Jesus. And what's... they say spring. Does that... what is their definition of spring? Does that mean sometime by the end of April or May or some shit?
I think it's probably considered somewhere in June to be the start of summer.
Yeah. May 31st is probably the release date. Then they're going to be like, sorry, that was a placeholder. Actually, we need until April of 2017. May 32nd, yes.
That's not a date. Shut up.
Shut up, you fucker! Anyway, so, in other news, apparently the president, the Bungie president, just stepped down as the acting CEO. The COO, what the fuck is a COO? There's too many C's in businesses.
Chief Operating Officer, I think.
What is it?
Sounds right.
I don't know what it does, but I think it's the next step down from CEO.
Yeah, sounds like the guy that actually does stuff. The COO, Pete Parsons, will now take over. And people were saying, and I mean, this is based on pure speculation, but they're kind of been insinuating he probably got, like, asked to step down. Just the way the announcement was made.
That's a bad thing.
Based on the fact that the new CEO is the one that announced the old CEO stepping down.
Well.
So, that's that, I guess. I have to say, if he's the one in charge of all that has been Destiny, good.
That's the impression I hope I got. The
new person is going to fucking change direction.
I mean, when the whole thing came out about what happened with the composer guy, like, it sounded like he was kind of the driving force behind screwing him over. So, like, he was the one that was basically in Activision's pocket and following what they said.
Yeah.
In that case, screw that guy.
Yeah. If that's true, fuck that guy. If that's
true, then good. Get out.
But either way, they need a new direction. The game is a fucking train wreck. Everyone has left. You know, it's, you know, we had our fun, and it sucks when you, you know, like I said, the Diablo developers had said their goal was that when you stopped playing the game, you left happy. You didn't leave because you were fucking pissed at what a piece of shit it was. And that's true. The last time I stopped playing Diablo 3, I just kind of stopped. Yeah. I was like, whatever. And I wasn't mad, and I wasn't like, fuck this shit. The first time I played, it was fuck this shit. I remember we all played Diablo 3, and slowly, one by one, we were all like, ugh, and just quit, right?
Yep.
But, you know, after they did all these changes and did all their shit, you know, it was good. And I would like to see them get to that point.
Yeah.
It's so frustrating to watch them make the exact, it's the same kind of game.
Mm-hmm.
And they make the exact same mistakes over and over and over. And when it comes down to it, when you keep telling your customers what fun is, which is what Bungie does too, what we think is how things are, like, if you keep doing that, no one is going to play your fucking game. Like, I know what I like to play because I'm not an infant and I can make decisions for myself. So when you tell me, no, what you want is, and no, it's not. I know what I want. I just, it's always that, like, every update they put out, and it was the same thing with Diablo. Every time they fix something, they'd break something again. Or every step forward, there was always two steps back with it.
Or they'd sneak in, like, changes that nobody wanted, try to get them under the radar. Or refuse
to make changes that people do want.
I think
because that's not their vision.
One of the funniest and worst things.
You
already
compromised your vision before you even released the game. So, sorry, what were you going to say?
Like, one of the funniest and worst things that happened with that was when they did one of the weapon balance patches. And what they said they had done for auto rifles was not even close to what they actually did. And they just left it for, like, not without saying anything for, like, over a week. And then they're like, oh, LOL, that was a typo. Like, no, you fuckers, you did this on purpose. Quit it.
Because then they never fixed it.
Yeah.
Well, typo. We meant to say, fuck you. I mean, what?
Like, the thing that infuriates me the most is, like, you can see the potential that the series has. Like, the, you know, the Destiny is capable of, and they're just not even attempting to go anywhere near it. They're just fucking dicking around now.
Yeah, I mean, the content shit they've been doing, every fucking stupid event that they had is some dumbass PvP thing.
Yeah.
They didn't say anything after the release of Taken King for, like, months. Everything they is like, whoa, how random are we? Look at these updates. Lo, 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 lo.
I don't even think Valentine's there was that. Day, like,
doubles.
The couple times I actually bothered to check when it wasn't some stupid holiday event, it was just, hey, here's our update. Our update is that we're going to update you on updates later.
Hey, look at this fun video somebody you don't give a fuck about made about a bunch of shit you don't care about. All those videos are like, let's find someone that for some reason still likes us and post a video. And it probably takes them a while.
Yeah, just as an example, like the second paragraph on their current update, prior to the holiday break, we mentioned a second larger update slated for spring. And then basically it's just them fucking stroking their dicks about how great this update is going to be, but not hardly telling you anything about it. Like, why even bother to update if all you're going to say is, hey, we're updating you that we're going to update later.
Yeah. But I'm not going to bitch about that all day. I just hope that they improve. That's what I want. I like the game has potential. It's always had potential. And they've squandered it with, you know.
As I always say,
it's a game with good gameplay and every other system, but the shooting is terrible. And it's true. Everything surrounding the shooting is god-awful. If this was a real RPG, it would be like 2 out of 10. But the shooting is really good and it's a shooting game, so that's what carries it. Hopefully, in the future, they will, you know, fill in the rest in a way that is actually satisfactory to people that play RPG games. And quite frankly, man, am I fucking tired of RNG. I don't think I want to play these games anymore. I think that, like, you know how in Kingdom Hearts, it's like, it's hard to get stuff, but you can do it? Like, that's fine. I don't mind if things are hard to get. Like, if it was hard to get a Yallerhorn, you know, or like the Black Spindle.
Yeah.
That mission drove me fucking crazy, and it makes me insane that you can only do it once every while. But the fact that it's really fucking hard, all right, I guess that's fine. It's kind of cheap, but, you know, when you do it, you get your shit, right?
Yeah.
Except, you know, that when the weapon wasn't a 310, it was useless. But that's besides the point. At least it was just, it's a thing you can do, and I like that kind of stuff, and I would hope they saw how much people liked that, and they do that more.
Yeah, like do this really hard thing that, you know, may not be easy to do, but you definitely get something for doing it.
Right. Going and doing a Nightfall and getting 9 strange coins is pretty much makes me want to stop playing the game forever. Like, can you remember the times? Like, you don't even hardly remember the good stuff because of how many bad times. Like, yeah. All the times you got, like, energy after you just spent an hour and a half cheesing the Nightfall. Like, oh my god. Everyone, like, we'd all get to the end and it'd be like, everyone was just mad. Like, I don't even care that I was playing it for fun, quote unquote. I'm just mad because I just got poop after I spent all that time playing. So, I don't know. Diablo 3 found a good balance with the, you know, the reward feedback. As you play, you get lots and lots of loot, and it's
so
it's
much
good.
Better now than it was.
Bungie needs to figure this shit out. That'll improve the game. So anyway, on to the EA corner.
Oh,
apparently,
boy.
EA is going to host a fan-focused event instead of a traditional E3 booth this year. I'm not really sure about exactly what all this is, but who put this one up, MT?
I don't know. Probably. It might have been me. I don't remember.
It is you.
It was like 5 weeks ago now. I don't remember shit.
It was only 3 weeks ago. But basically,
yeah, here's the quote that was spouted out there about it. We are taking our commitment to put our players first further this year by creating a play experience built around them. Hosting our own event allows us to connect directly with our players and create a meaningful experience for them. In Los Angeles, our players will have access to the games on Monday, which, whatever that is, June 12th, it looks like.
Yeah, is this...
We will...
Like, they're not going to be doing, like, instead of having a booth at all, they're going to be going and taking their ball and going to their own convention?
Basically, yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah, it'll be it. I don't know if it's going to be like a super huge. Let's see, one. The one, at least one, I don't know. It sounds like they'll do more than one of these, but one will take place in Los Angeles at Club Nokia. I don't know what that is, but.
It's basically right across the street from the convention center.
Oh. Is that that place that everyone that can't get their shit into E3 goes to?
Kind of. like when we saw Muse a couple weeks ago at that Staples Center, it was like close to it.
Oh, okay.
In that same little, like, metropolitan area.
I see.
Like a smaller area, but...
Yeah.
Yeah. which is, I mean, it's probably fine for them. So,
I mean, they're already checking everything out there already anyway. They're just putting it in a different building now.
Yeah.
Which I think that's kind of neat. You know, it's kind of sucky that it's so hard to, like, you have to be in the industry to get into E3. So that, yeah. That kind of, well, I mean, that kind of sucks. Yeah. I mean, I understand it, but it still sucks.
This is a positive spin on that, because yeah, like it sounds like the first day will be just for like fans, and then they won't, like the industry people get to come in the next day.
That fan day is going to be such a clusterfuck, though.
Yeah,
definitely. What is EA even going to be showing?
I'd like to go, but like, there's no fucking way I get to play anything I want to. We'll have a Mass Effect, or not Mass Effect. Well, they might have Mass Effect, maybe like a trailer or something to show.
Probably.
Mirror's Edge, we'll have that probably playable. To some degree.
I'll see. They got a website. Do they have anything out here? No, they don't. We'll just have a sign up to stay informed thing.
All right, then.
No, they don't.
Basically, it's just, hey, look, we're doing a thing. Sign up to hear about our thing. It'll be fun.
I can do thing. So, I don't know. That's kind of a neat idea. I like that. What I think would be best would be just, I don't know. On the one hand, it'd be cool to open up EA or to open up E3 to the public, but then on the other hand, like if you've been to a convention before, oh my god, it would just be an absolute fuckfest. Like as it is now, it's relatively limited, and even then, it still looks like a fuckfest when you see pictures. So, I don't know.
Well, Tokyo Game Show has a couple, like at least 2 days, I think, that are open to the public. Like they could do the normal E3 conference during the week, and then Thursday and Friday, when they would normally be sending stuff back, they could have a couple fan days then.
Yeah, just tag it on to the end after all the conferences are done and all that shit. Definitely a possibility. They're not gonna. Then it'd be more like PAX, which I guess if we want that, we have that. We have PAX. Except there's not one of those in LA. Then what? What is it in, like, Seattle or some shit?
PAX Seattle, I think Seattle, Boston, and then Texas.
PAX Maine that literally sells out apparently within like 15 minutes, like a fucking Adele concert.
Yep.
Or BlizzCon.
I think they're starting one in Texas now.
Yep.
Which I might consider doing that. At least I can see Xylus and Betty and Annelle and Vertigo. Everybody. So, anyway, that seems like a neat idea. I'm down with that.
Anything that gives normal people access to games they wouldn't get to play otherwise is a good thing, in my opinion.
Yeah. Just like the whole idea behind it. It sounds like they're doing it, like, they're basically doing it before E3 happens. So, you know, people that are in the area for E3, like, there it is.
Yeah, it also seems like E3 in and of itself is kind of less and less important every year.
Yeah.
And another interesting news in the EA corner.
On the other end of the spectrum.
They're on a journey to regain PC gamers' trust. It's not necessarily the opposite end of the spectrum.
Well, this is EA we're talking about, though. They make statements like this like at least once a year.
Well, yeah, everything they say is hollow and meaningless. But, you know, I'll give them credit. Origin is actually not that bad. And one thing I will give them kudos for that they are massively better at, ironically enough, their customer service is 10 times better than anything Steam has. They instituted the refund policy that very likely may have forced Steam to do something similar. They have phone queues you can call. They have IM chats you can do. Their support is like, it's a whole different level. Steam support, as anyone who's ever done anything on Steam ever, is non-existent. And I will at least give them kudos for that. They've done stupid shit, and no one liked Origin when it first came out. And it's still kind of annoying that they kind of took their ball and went home, you know? Like, we're only going to put our games here. But at the same time, when you think about it, like, isn't that what Valve did? I'd say the people that are coolest about it are probably, as stupid as this probably sounds, but Ubisoft, you can still buy your shit on Steam if you want. And they've made it so that, what's it called, isn't a giant piece of shit anymore.
Uplay.
Right. It just kind of is there, and it's nowhere near as annoying as it used to be. And it's not like we're in 1995 where you're where one program running in the background taking up 30 megabytes of RAM is going to fucking kill your computer, right? Like, I have 16 gigs of memory, and anyone that has a gaming PC is probably looking at something similar to that. For instance, Origin, 80 megs. It's not going to break anything. Like, no one's going to be harmed by that. Chrome is probably taking up, I don't even want to know.
Yeah, Chrome easily takes up the most for me.
500-600 megs, probably. Pretty easily.
Yeah, but I have like 20 tabs open right now.
Yeah, but still.
It's fucking ridiculous. I actually can't find anywhere that will show me where the total memory usage is, because every tab is its own process.
So yeah, it's all split between them.
Irritating fucking insanity. But yeah, I don't think it's that big of a deal. Stuff running in the background's not killing your PC. Except maybe Skype. I hate that fucking program. So, I don't know, whatever. There's an article about it, but they didn't really say anything. It's just like, we're great.
It's just basically saying we have this program, and we have the Games on the House program, and we're trying. That's,
yeah, look at all the things we've done for you.
They are kind of trying. The Game on the House thing, that's a cute little thing, you know? Taking a page out of the PlayStation in general, Plus Xbox like book.
Their actions are speaking well, but when they use phrases like "we're on a journey to regain trust,"
yeah, can everyone please give us a pat on the back? The point where you're like, "Come on, just fucking do it! Stop looking for a blowjob just because you're not shooting people in the face anymore." Okay,
like just because of EA being who EA is, if they would have just never said anything, it probably would have gone better than them saying something. Just do these things, and everybody's like, "All right." And then you say something like this, and everybody's like, what do you want?
Fine, what?
Yeah. What's the catch?
Anyhow, you are the only one that probably cares. What's this Battlefront stuff?
Basically, they've actually just finally said anything about what their fucking DLC is going to be. Because, you know, how long ago did they announce their stupid fucking season pass?
Which, I still don't understand. Why does anyone buy those? Because the reason I ask that, you don't get anything special for buying a season pass. And they'll sell the season pass all the way up until after they've released all the DLC. So why would you do that? And it's not like if you buy the game with the season pass, you save money, because you don't. It's just if the season pass is $30 and the game is $60, the special edition with season pass is $90. So...
Like, so I want to say in the case of Battlefront, it was a bit cheaper just because it's $50.
Which
is insane.
That's insane. Yeah.
Like, and then, well, not only $50, but $50 and you had absolutely zero, like less than zero information about what it would entail. No less than like, zero. Release schedule.
They literally took information they released out of your mind.
Pretty much, yeah.
That's amazing. That's some Darth Vader shit.
Pretty much.
I knew EA was evil, that's crazy.
Like, usually when there's like a season
their CEO
pass
does tend to dress like a supervillain, so...
Well, I mean, like, even with, like, Destiny, you know, they're like, hey, season pass, and it will be this and this. They didn't give you any information beyond that, but at least they told you how much, you know, kind of what the things would be about. But this, it was just, there's a season pass.
I bought that, but I feel stupid having bought that now. I wanted the collector's edition, I guess. But why?
No.
I think that people should just stop buying these. Like, don't. Because they can put out half-ass DLC or like the Batman one. It was costumes. A season pass for fucking costumes? What? Don't call that DLC. I'm not buying your fucking season pass for that.
But anyways, yeah, so they've like laid out their plan for like the entirety of their season pass, which it spans all the way through into 2017.
I know, I was looking at that, I was like, jeez.
Which you can tell some of this they're lining up, like, you know, they're releasing their Death Star themed one right about the time that Rogue One's gonna come out, so they know what they're doing.
Yeah, wink, 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 nudge, nudge, look at that.
But the thing that kind of surprised me about it is like between like the actual paid, like, you know, DLC stuff for this, there's going to be a lot of free additions too. Like, they're adding free maps here and there. They're adding free, you know, game modes and stuff like that. So even after this stuff starts coming out, they're still putting out free content too, which is...
What is this stuff, though? Nice. Is it just, like, maps, modes? What the fuck
maps,
is this?
Maps, hero characters, weapons, like, the ability cards.
I guess I just don't get it anymore. I just don't care enough with multiplayer games. Like, I just...
I had a lot of fun with the game. I really enjoyed it.
I just mean, like, why would I buy this?
Well, yeah, I still haven't bought any of the DLC. Like, I'll see how it is when it comes out.
It's just, like, this kind of stuff doesn't change the game in any meaningful way. I guess if I played so much that I was just, like, sick to death of the maps, but I just, I don't know.
Like, I enjoy the game enough that I'd be interested in, like, you know, just the description of, you know, what some of the maps are going to be. I'd be like, I'd like to try that. I'm not sure if I want to pay the amount they're going to ask to try it, but
right,
we'll see when it gets to that point. We're not setting anywhere near foot anywhere near like the season pass until I know very specifically what I'm going to be seeing.
And it's just once the DLC releases now, every time it's bad news because it fractures the community.
Yeah, every time. That's other because like they've released a few maps now for free. Uh-huh. I want to say there's been like 3 or 4 now. You know, sometimes they're cool. Just like, you know, smaller themed maps for what a bigger one they already have, but you know, it's still something different. Or like they have the couple like single player things they have in the game had like exclusive maps that they put into the multiplayer after the fact, which is fine. But yeah, if they throw in like a ton of maps with these things, it's just gonna cause problems.
Yeah. It's gonna be like Titanfall where we went to find games. And we didn't have the season pass yet, remember? We all bought it because it went on sale. And it was like, you couldn't find a fucking game. And I just, like, that shit sucks. I don't want to fucking deal with that. Annoying.
Or they'll do what Titanfall also did and, you know, make you pay for all these maps and then realize how fucking retarded they are and then give them away for free, which kind of annoys you because you paid for all of them.
Yeah.
Especially whatever, that's all it was for that.
Speaking of Titanfall, apparently they have set Titanfall to come out March, Titanfall 2 to come out in March 2017. And it's going to be on PS4, Xbox One, and PC. It'll be interesting. I'm curious to see how the game is going to do on PS4. I would like to have it on PC. I would like to play a new one. But at the same time, I feel the same way I feel about the first one, and it's just gonna.
Well, it seemed fun at first, but like then, like I don't know, it didn't feel right after playing it for a little while. Like the balance and everything felt so awkward. Enjoy it.
That came back to, and we talked about that a lot. There's no matchmaking based on skill.
Yeah, so that too.
We'd group up. And we'd be playing like fucking MLB wannabes, right? MLG wannabes. Fucking
Major League Baseball wannabes.
Yeah. MLB wannabes who want to join the MLG. And we'd jump in there and literally within seconds, all of us would be dead. And it'd be like, ah, one of these. And you just knew, like, from that point forward, you were not going to have fun. And it was hit or miss whether that was going to happen to you again.
Oh.
So it's really fucking frustrating.
Well, at least now you'll have a single player portion to play, so that's kind of good.
Yeah, and what even is that going to be, I wonder?
Probably the actual like, campaign, just like Call of Duty style, I imagine.
Lead writer. I wonder who their lead writer is. Is it anyone that makes games that are good? A grounded, dirty, and human world. I mean, it can't be worse than Destiny, right?
That's going to be the new bar for...
That's not a high bar. Is it worse than nothing?
The low bar.
God. I don't know. It sounds interesting, at least. I like that they're going to make a real single player. I'm not sure why they're doing a TV series. I get really... If, like, I don't... When I see shit like that, I'm like, because it's like, I don't know if I want to watch a TV show about a video game because it's probably going to be stupid. And then, like, do I have to watch this for the game to make sense? I don't know. We'll see.
I wouldn't be surprised if the TV show were kind of a prequel, because they really don't, from what I remember, they didn't really go into too much detail about why the world is the way it is.
And I'm interested in that world because I know nothing about it.
Oh,
it seems interesting.
I think I remember it was saying something about how, like, the mechs used to be more, like, agricultural, and then, like, at some point they became war machines instead.
Yeah. It'd definitely be interesting to see more about that. And it'd be fun. It'd be nice if it was a fun campaign. I think the thing about games like Call of Duty and Titanfall is the campaign is boring because you're a guy with a gun, and that never changes. You're just a dude running around with a gun for an entire game, and the guns don't change because they're fairly realistic. They all just fire like bullets and stuff. If you contrast that with, say, like Resistance,
where they fire weasels.
Right, basically. I mean, the Resistance games, every gun is like fucking crazy. In Call of Duty, every gun is just like a fucking just normal gun. Like, there's nothing exciting about it. Like, now this one looks like this and fires bullets really fast. And this one looks like this and fires them a little faster and they hurt less. But there's nothing really, like, exciting as you progress through the campaign. And the story's not that good either. So those two things, like an story coupled with basically no progression of your character at all, just kind of makes the campaign boring. I think that's why I never enjoyed the Call of Duty campaign. It's just kind of boring. If the writing were better, maybe it might have been more fun. Like, you guys remember the Medal of Honor games, right?
I remember them. I didn't play them very much. I mean, I think I played. Wait, no, was Medal of Honor or was it?
I never played the single player part of that. I always like it. I've been to a couple LAN parties where I just played it multiplayer.
Oh, I think the first two.
I think I played one of the PC only ones. I think.
Oh, that would have probably been Assault. That was a few games in. The first couple, you know, they like had a story and you played through and it was about World War II and shit. But I don't know. I think war games just have a tendency to get fucking boring. For me, at least. I think it's hard. Like, at least a sci-fi shooter game can throw out, you know, crazy shit for you to try. Weird guns or learning new tech powers and stuff like that. Like, Killzone was still pretty fun because you kept, as you progressed, you got new guns and new stuff happened, you know? That's just not part of a Call of Duty game. Like, Call of Duty is just like, here's this gun, run over there and shoot that. And that's every level. This time you have a shotgun. This time you have an assault rifle. Like, nothing really changes. Contrast that with, like, Resistance. It's like, this level, go shoot those guys with this gun that shoots through fucking walls. That's awesome. So, the movement thing, though, I think it does keep things a little more exciting.
Oh,
at least
was,
they can make some platforming stuff with that.
That was one of my favorite things about that game. It's just the sense of freedom and movement you had.
Yeah, I think that's what made it worth playing, you know? I was already starting to get sort of, you know, I hadn't bought a Call of Duty game in a while, and I was like, I don't know. But the movement made it interesting. I think they should try to sneak in some, like, Mirror's Edge type of tricky shit in there, you know, just to make things more interesting.
Wow.
And I mean, it's fucking EA. They make Mirror's Edge. Grab one of those guys and have them help design some shit. Mirror's Edge with guns. I would buy that.
Mirror's buy Edge the hell had out of guns.
That. Not really, though. If you use guns, you suck, basically. Like, you're supposed to run around and, you know,
well, there
not
was a,
use guns.
There was an achievement / trophy for not using a gun the whole time.
Yeah.
Which I got, because that game was fucking awesome.
We'll need to play that.
Do it. Jesus. Do you own it yet?
Yeah, they gave it away for free on PlayStation Plus.
It's been like $5 or free.
It's probably free on Origin at some point, too.
Yeah, that's what you meant, right?
Plan to play. I've been trying to slowly dig through my backlog.
Yeah.
I'm finally almost done with the One Kingdom Hearts game I was playing, so then I can move on to other stuff. trying to dig, like, you know, burn through a few PS3 ones before I jump into Witcher 3, because I know it's going to be a long time before I play anything else after that.
I just gave up on my PS3 games. I was just like, fuck it. I'm never going to play that one, that weird RPG that launched with the PS3. What was it called? There's a guy in it that reminded me of, I think you had him as your avatar for a while. What the hell was that game called? It was a weird RPG game. I can't remember. Why can't I remember?
What was that called?
I know. I'm trying to fucking Google it and I cannot find it. It was a PS3 exclusive, right?
Oh, yeah.
How the fuck can I not find this?
Jesus Christ.
No, it was not Jesus Christ.
No, it was. It totally was.
Jesus Christ, the video game.
Did it have something to do with...
No, it didn't have anything to do with sighing.
Why can't I fucking think of the name of this thing?
Must not have been a very good game.
It was the most Kyle-looking game when I saw it. It's like, every time I saw the game, I just thought, Kyle, I bet he loves this.
I don't know why.
Damn it.
I wanted to, Kyle. But never quite got around to it.
I bet the reason I can't find it is it actually turns out it was probably not actually that good, and that's why I can't find it on any list of fucking games.
From what I recall, it was just kind of okay. I remember reading of it, which is kind of why I stayed away from it, because I didn't have the money to spend on just kind of okay games.
Folklore?
Yes, I think that was
That's it. Yeah, look at this cover.
I don't even remember that.
Bell's Kyle.
Actually, no, wait, I'm not sure if I should be
insulted by that or not.
No, it looks like the guy on the front looks like Otacon, and there's a bunch of weird fairy shit all around. It's pretty much Kingdom Hearts with adults.
I know.
No.
God, that game looks terrible just by the art. Sorry.
It was a launch game. It looks like they developed it on the fucking built-in SDK. Doesn't look at the stupid action bar. That fucking bar in the little screenshot, it's like they took the developer's kit and just default settings the whole way through.
It almost looks like it would be like a cell phone game.
Hey. I mean, it was a launch PS3 game, I think.
I mean, with the interface, yeah, not necessarily the way it looks. Wasn't
right on launch, it was within like a month or two of launch.
Yeah.
Something like that.
I don't think that this developer does anything anymore. Yep.
Not really.
Shut down. Defunct as of June 2011. You had not really that good of a run. There's a bunch of shit no one has played on this list.
You had a run?
I also made a game called Dark Misk. What'd you play?
Genji, Dawn of the Samurai on PlayStation 2.
That's giant the kind enemy
of
cover.
That's the kind of. Like, I see that game case that looks so fucking boring.
Also,
like, if I saw that at the store and didn't know what it is, I'd be like, is this something that, like, this is the kind of game that grandmas buy their fucking grand. Yeah.
Basically, because I think I actually bought it for like $3 to $5 out of the bargain bin at Fry's.
Oh, I believe you. It came out of the bargain bin game.
It came out a year after the PlayStation 3 did.
Like that fucking game, I remember there was a demo for, because I think it was just called Pirates on the Xbox.
Sounds awful.
It was so fucking stupid. It wasn't Sid Meier's Pirates. It was just some dumb fucking Pirates game. I'll have to find it one day. Be like, look, it's terrible. Pirates, The Legend of Black Cat. I think that's what it was. Maybe it wasn't even an Xbox game. This is a multiplat, yo. 3.5 out of 5 on Metacritic. Maybe it wasn't as terrible as I thought. I can remember getting this and I was like, why? Why would you do this? Anyway. An equally mystifying terms here. Okay, apparently the next Insomniac game, you know, the developers of Ratchet and Clank, and also Resistance, right?
Yep.
And they did Sunset Overdrive?
Yes, I believe so.
The next game is going to be published by GameStop.
Fucking GameStop. Apparently,
they're desperate.
I don't know what this is. It looks like a swim in the aquarium game. Like, this looks like a phone game. I don't know why.
This is referring to it. It says it's a 2D Metroidvania style game set in an underwater world.
You know, I think that those words get used like way too much anymore to the point that Metroidvania doesn't fucking mean anything. Because when I think of Metroid, I don't think of a submarine floating in water.
Yeah, well, I thought maybe that was just part of it, but every single screenshot is that. So yeah, I agree with you.
You can call it an Igavania. That's what he's trying to call it for some fucking reason.
Okay, no.
Yeah, exactly. Like, no, you moron. You didn't make these games. Go away.
Oh, well. Oops, that was really loud.
Ruin everything.
It looks... eh.
Meh.
I mean, I could see why this is why GameStop's the only people that would publish this.
The only thing I think of is maybe it was just something they were like developing on the side, and
like somebody got bored at the office. Was just like, and like,
we don't want that.
Hey, can we? No. It just looks like like a PlayStation Network game. It doesn't look like
something that might have been funded on Kickstarter.
Oh, wait, there's a chick swimming around during the video for, like, 2 seconds. Like, this game, though, like, this is, like, let's take the part of Mario that no one likes and make an entire fucking game where you swim around in water. Like, it looks terrible to me. But whatever.
What it kind of makes me think of with the submarine is, I don't know if you remember... it's an old NES game, Blaster Master.
Yep.
No.
That's what I'm thinking of.
Okay.
I guess so, in that it takes place inside of a vehicle and it's Metroidvania-ish.
Yeah, that's probably what they mean. They call it a Metroidvania-style game.
Okay, well, people need to stop using those terms, because...
Oh, to be fair, Blaster Master, I think, came out before... Metroidvania was a term. Well, it definitely came up before Metroidvania was a term. Sorry, I was going to say it might have come out before Metroid, but I don't think it did.
Came out in 1988.
Damn, that shit's
Metroid
old.
Was 87?
Dat NES. Sunsoft Inc.
Sunsoft was quality, man. They made that first NES Batman game.
What?
That was really good, but fucking hard.
I don't remember that.
They actually made a few decent games.
I was playing. 3 years old when that game released, so... You know.
You fucking child.
Oh, shit. You they did that that NES Addams Family game, too. That game was fun.
Fester's Quest. I never actually played that game.
Actually, it was harder than fuck, but...
I bet. It looked interesting, but I never...
They made Arrow the Acrobat. I remember that game. That game was fucking weird.
That's back when everyone was trying to make a...
Waku 7!
Fucking Arrow the Acrobat was when everyone was trying to have a mascot like Sonic the Hedgehog.
The Death and Return of Superman? Wasn't that also... I thought that was Blizzard. Oh, man. Wasn't that game awful? I don't remember.
This is a side-scrolling beat-em-up.
Oh, one of those... one of those games that every single... intellectual property existed had a beat-em-up made of it in the 90s.
Every comic book character you can think of had one.
Yep.
Oh, shit, they did the Gremlins game, too.
Anyway.
They did Bugs Bunny Rabbit Rampage. Some quality shit, man.
Welcome to the List Sunsoft Games podcast. I'm your host.
Wish I wasn't here.
I want to kill myself.
That's not your name, you're MT.
That's what it stands for. Somehow, I don't know. Shut up. Let's move on.
So, Good Old Games is doing Steam Greenlight in a way that's not retarded. I think that just about sums it up, huh?
Yeah, basically.
Next,
Kyle,
story.
Take it away.
So they're starting their own early access thing called
What's it
Games
called?
In Development.
That's
pretty straightforward. Yeah.
How did they ever come up with that title? Jesus.
Apparently, they did not waste any time on naming it. So,
I mean, Good Old Games is pretty fucking literal too.
Yeah, that's kind of their thing. I guess.
Their thing.
Yeah. But anyways, like the some of the things they kind of set forth that they're doing with it is all the games are DM free, or DRM free, of course, because that's how they roll. Yeah. They have a 14-day no questions asked return policy. All the games that will go into it are actually handpicked by them. It's not a voting thing or anything like that. They themselves like vet the developer and everything to avoid all the shovelware asset flip bullshit.
So they're kind of like acting as a real publisher almost.
Yeah.
Just with, you know, they don't give them money and they're not that picky.
Yeah. But then kind of the coolest thing with it is, you know, via the, because they have their own client and everything. Like when you put in for a game that's like in development like this, as it updates and stuff like that, you can actually refuse to update it and stick to the version you have if you want.
I thought that was an interesting little.
Yeah, like if you update it and you don't like the new version or it's too buggy, at that point you can roll it back to a previous version and stick with that until they fix their shit.
I don't think anyone's ever done that before.
Yeah, and like even after the game is complete and fully released and everything, they'll basically have like snapshots of different versions of the game. So at any point, you can go back and look at the development cycle of the game and see what they did with it and try earlier versions and stuff, which is a really neat idea.
That seems like that'll take up a lot of space after a certain point.
Probably, but it doesn't seem like they plan on, like, you know, just pumping shit through this. Like, they're only doing, like, a few at a time.
Yeah, and it's not every game it's on good. The service. It's just early access type stuff.
Yeah. But, I mean, it has potential. It's nice to see people trying new things.
Yeah, totally.
All right, so then we got this Ant Simulator thing.
Oh, Jesus.
There's been an update, by the way.
Another one?
Well, about his partners, they responded.
Yeah. I don't think I've seen anything about it since then.
You can describe this one. It's retarded.
Jesus. Okay, so I think the easiest thing is just going to be kind of read through the whole
deal. Just jump in, Kyle. Deal.
Yeah. So, Ant Simulator was one of those games, you know, that was on Kickstarter that got funded. That's basically what it sounds like. I mean, it looked really cool. It was very, like...
Does it? It looks like I would never, ever boot this up because I might run into a spider and have to blow up my computer.
Well, yeah, but I mean, the fact that the spider looks that fucking creepy...
Is why I will never pay it. Play it.
Yeah, but or other people, it. Like, I mean... Yeah. The quality of it therein is, you know, says something about it. Anyway, yeah, because I probably wouldn't either. But anyway, yeah,
you'd nope the fuck out of there.
Bro. Yeah, just that picture of the spider they have in this article. It's like, oh god,
I have to keep scrolling up so I don't have to see it. I'm like, no.
Yeah, you can hit that X and it'll get rid of the pictures.
Yay!
Or the big picture, anyways. Okay, anyways. Well, yeah, they funded it. It was, you know, they were getting regular updates and stuff. And then, like, I guess, like, the updates started getting kind of sporadic. And then finally, like, the guy that was kind of helming the project, like, ended up updating. And this is kind of what he said. This is going to be the worst video I've ever... Oh, he actually did a video explaining what's happened with the game. But yeah, he says, this is going to be the worst video I've ever had to make. I can't work on Ant Simulator anymore. I recently found out my ex-business partners were secretly stealing company money. They had secretly spent the overwhelming majority of both our Kickstarter money and the Ant Simulator investment money on liquor, restaurants, bars, and even strippers. This is the reason it has become exceedingly clear to me that I cannot have my career associated with these guys. So basically, the game got canned supposedly because of this whole deal. You know, these guys, like the two guys he was making the game with, apparently had been embezzling money, so on and so forth. It was a pretty shit deal. And then he says, like, I'm very pissed off I lost money. I lost over a year in work. And I lost a game that I loved and I was proud of. And I was really looking forward to releasing on Steam and PS4. It's supposed to be my first big step and really taking a shot at making video games as a career. But I have to start over now. And then he was working on trying to get people their money back if he could. But it was left like that for a few days. And then like the article got updated, I think, within the week. And the two business partners, it was basically a response from the two business partners that he was like calling out. And
100% bullshit.
Yeah. It's completely false. I don't know why he's painting that picture. But the reality is that anything that was spent in a bar or restaurant was a very reasonable or was very reasonable in nature when you look at any business, including video game companies. It was part of our operations budget. It's not anything that was excessive. It's all reported to the IRS. The picture he's painting about that is 100% bullshit. So, and then I haven't heard anything about it since then. So it was basically like, these guys did this. And they're like, nope, nah. And then it just kind of fell off the earth.
Montz, who served as the director of finance, says the books were open. According to him, there was no opportunity for clandestine embezzlement because he had access to all the financial data. And he said, according to them, things were going well until November of last year. Shortly after Thanksgiving, this guy made the decision to cut ties with the rest of the company. In doing so, he allegedly made the unilateral decision to close the firm's business accounts. And they said he took control of everything. He took control of not only all the company's physical properties, our bank accounts, our social media accounts, our website, which he changed to just our faces for some unknown reason. That was all him. This all started to take place right after the game started to get really popular in the late summer. My personal theory is he just wanted to take it all for himself and cut us out. We made it clear that we weren't going to let him do that because we had a moral and legal right not to. And then he said, according to the two of them, he moved the company funds to a personal account. That money was still being used to support the development of the game, which the two people said included the 9 or 10 independent contractors. Man, there's a lot of shit in this article.
Yeah. Like, I mean, it was like both things are pretty thorough, and then like it just kind of dropped there, apparently. Yeah, I haven't seen anything about it since then.
The guy actually is full of shit. Because these people are saying a lot.
Yeah. Like,
and if they're paying 9 or 10 contractors, how the fuck could they have spent all the money and still paid the contractors?
Well.
So, I don't know. Sounds like drums. Basically.
It was a pretty hardcore falling out either way. Because I think, like, at least two of them had been, like, childhood friends or something like that.
Well, it might be the two that are still together.
Oh, maybe. Kind of sucks either way, you know, like...
Well, it sucks for people that wanted to buy the game, and now they're getting screwed over by a bunch of petty drama.
It's kind of the risk with shit like Kickstarter, but you don't see stuff fall out that badly very often, it seems like. Kickstarter seems to do a pretty good job of, like, holding people to the... They say... I don't know. It just kind of sucks, you know, it seemed like, you know, the game had potential, even though I didn't care.
I just think it sucks all these people paid the money and now they're getting fucked.
Unlikely,
that's what
yeah.
I think sucks.
Oh, yeah, that sucks too, but...
What a shame. Anyway, another stupid news. EA and Ubisoft are fighting over the word ghost. I don't think there's really much more to say than that. It's retarded. Ubisoft, I think, EA is trying to trademark the word ghost. Yeah. And Ubisoft's like, no, we're already using it.
Like, at least on, like, in this particular case, I mean, it's still retarded as fuck, but I see why they wanted to, because they actually have a developer called Ghost.
Yeah.
So it's a little different than, like, King going, yeah, we're just gonna trademark the word candy because we use it in one of our games. Okay, thanks.
Still, like, you can't.
But so, yeah,
fuck off.
Well, it's also better than Sony trying to trademark Let's Play.
Here's a word that people have been using for years. Let's trademark that.
Idiots.
I'm going to trademark the word rainbow so no one can ever use it again. Pay me money. Welcome to EA, sir.
Welcome trademarked aboard. By Pat Roberts. I'll show those gays.
Not the same person.
Whatever. I don't care anymore. I started looking at something else when I was talking. So, Nintendo's starting up their new rewards program. But it doesn't say anything. I really wish when they said things that they would actually like share information that was useful.
Especially since it's supposed to launch next month.
Everything in the screenshots here is in fucking Japanese. And apparently they felt the need to report it, but not actually tell us what any of it fucking means. Oh, look, it's The Escapist. Why am I not surprised? Let's see. So, you know, the old program they had stopped a while ago. They're going to do it again, and they're going to have two types of coins, platinum and gold. From the looks of things, because we don't have any translators that speak Japanese, platinum coins will be used for the old Nintendo Club type stuff, physical rewards and all that kind of stuff, while the gold coins will be used for deals, savings on purchasing games and stuff. Nintendo also mentioned that Miitomo, what the fuck is that?
It's their first mobile game thing.
Oh. It's the first smartphone app will begin pre-registration on February 17th. And that's the thing I'm pretty sure I saw and went, oh, Kirogi, looks dumb. It looks like a game where you create a me. I don't really know what it is. Miitomo. Anyway, so, you know, it's good that they're looking to do that. Does it actually say... It's just this March. I guess there's no specific date. Interesting to see what the deals thing is. I hope if they do deals that they maybe have deals on, like, not digital things, because fuck Nintendo and fuck their digital shit.
Yeah.
I feel nervous even just buying fucking Smash Brothers DLC because of their ridiculous practices. Although, MT, you just dealt with this recently. You should share that. What all happened?
Do I really have to?
Yes, MT.
It was a horrible experience, and he doesn't want to relive it.
Was it horrible, or was it just mildly annoying?
It was frustrating. Basically, I had bought the white 8GB Wii U back when they first came out, because I was like one person too late. I really wanted.
Oh, that's right. So I was going to say, you didn't buy that because you wanted it. You buy that because that was all you could get.
Yeah. Well, anyway, it's a long story. I'm not going to get into. But basically, I bought the last two characters, Bayonetta and Corrin, I believe is how you say it. But on my system memory, I had no more space on the hard drive to put the update for the game, so for Smash Brothers, so I couldn't play it. So I was basically screwed, because that's the only game I really play on that system at the moment. There's also really nothing else I could delete. The only other things on the system I had, other than the Smash Brothers information, whatever that was stuff for Super Mario Maker. And even if I deleted that, that would have only freed up like 300 megabytes, and the update needed at least a gig. So that definitely wouldn't have made a difference. So I said, you know what, fuck it, I'll trade my Wii U in, I'll get like $100 for it around that, and then I'll use that money to buy a 32 gig Wii U. So I did that. Before I did that, though, I went online trying to make sure I did everything the right way, because I know Nintendo's very stingy about their...
everything.
Yeah. Pretty much. But like the way the Nintendo network IDs like work is they're supposed to be like basically hard coded into that system they're created on, and you're not supposed to be able to transfer them. They mentioned that there are ways you can delete that stuff, but from what I could figure out, from what I saw, it wasn't too clear on exactly how you do it right. They made it sound like you could just format the Wii U hard drive and that would get rid of it. But apparently that wasn't the case, because when I tried to sign on to my ID on the new Wii U, it said, nope, you can't. It's on the old system. So, like, instead of making it real simple to just, you know, say, deactivate this serial number for this, you know, account, I had to basically call Nintendo tech support, tell them the situation, like, I don't have access to the Wii U anymore. It's at GameStop. I can't go back and ask them to boot it
can
up.
Can you please let me do things?
Yeah. So basically, I just called them. I was like, okay, he verified who I was and whatnot, and then said, okay, in like one or two business days, you'll receive an email saying that it's off the old system and you can use it again. So I basically had to wait a day or two before I could actually use my Wii U. I mean, I could have created a new account on it, but that was not really the point. Like, I wanted my old...
Wanted your shit back.
Yeah, I wanted my Smash Bros. Characters. I just paid, you know, $10 or whatever it was for both of them. And I didn't want to have to redo that. I thought about making a new account, but then I realized, you know, I'm going to have to download all this, or have to buy all that stuff again, so I might as well just keep what I have. So, you know, in the grand scheme of things, it's not a big deal, but it just kind of shows how like, stupid Nintendo is when it comes to online things.
Yeah, they don't know how to do things good.
They don't know how to do stuff good.
Yeah.
Well, whatever. It's figured out now. Who cares?
Enormous pain in the ass. I genuinely don't understand why they are the way that they are. At least you got to sort it out. Sounds like a super pain in the ass, but at least it did get fixed, and you didn't have to like send your fucking Wii to them or anything insane.
Yeah, I was kind of worried about that at first.
Yeah, it's like, oh Christ!
At least the guy I talked to was you know knowledgeable and knew what he was doing, so it wasn't like I was talking to a moron.
Really goes a long way. Not talking to a moron.
It really does.
In other even dumber news, the Linux and Mac ports of Arkham Knight have been canceled. I guess they pretty much just threw in the fucking towel.
30 gamers are now upset.
Like, they fucking can't even really fix the Windows version, so they're like, yeah, whatever. I don't think anyone's particularly surprised. It's kind of sucky, because it was neat that they were even going to make a Linux and Mac version. It's kind of lame that they just gave up, but I guess they don't feel like actually fixing their product. I'm kind of glad that the Batman games by Rocksteady are done now, because now I don't have to buy any more games from the WB games anymore. kind of tired of their fucking bullshit, to be honest. We've already gone over this like 900 times, so I'm not going to get into it again, but they pretty much suck shit, and this whole thing is embarrassing.
Yeah, but eventually there's going to be another DC superhero game that you might be interested in, and it will always be them.
Just fucking stop it.
Stop it.
Stop it. Anyway, so we got one. Looks like Kojima and Del Toro are going to be hosting a conference at the DICE Summit. What is that?
Didn't we go over this last time we recorded a podcast?
I'm pretty sure we did.
Was that literally the...
No, it's not the developer.
Okay. We did go over this.
It's a completely different thing. What acronym for something dealing with?
Developers.
Hey, yeah. Pete Holmes is going to be there. That's the guy from the those Call of Humor Batman videos. The Batman videos.
Oddly enough, the event itself starts today. Today being
today for us.
Tuesday. Yeah. When this podcast goes up, it will have been started.
16th to the 18th.
So, hey, that's cool. I mean, there's not really that much to say, but it's kind of like, wink, wink, they're going to do that game.
Well, no, they still want to do something like with each other. So.
Yeah, I'm sure they really do, because like, they were fucking like...
Besties.
Let's do this shit, guys.
Now Kojima's free. He's finally free.
I just love this this image, like for the announcement for this, like the picture of Kojima. He's trying to be all like creepy and mysterious looking, and
looks like he's just like, trying to take over the world.
I like making movies about weird shit.
I expect you to die. I seriously hope you do not write it.
I made Pan's Labyrinth. What the fuck is wrong with me?
Hey, he also made the Hellboy movies.
He did. What? There's something wrong with that guy. Those things are creepy as shit.
They're so good.
They are.
So also at DICE, Todd Howard, the game director and executive producer at Bethesda Game Studios, is getting an award of some sort. I can't
Lifetime
see it in this article
achievement.
Now. Yeah, that's what it was. Thank you. This article didn't seem to say it. I thought they were talking about it, but... They're not.
It was in the title, I think, and apparently nowhere in the article itself. That makes sense.
But yeah, you know, he's been around for fucking forever, it seems like. I think,
some really cool news, too. Apparently, something I've never seen before, The Division on console is going to let you change visual settings to improve the frame rate. That's cool
crazy.
As shit. That's some PC level stuff. So that's neat. I guess, you know, I like that because, you know, if you don't care about some of the extra added shit and you just want to turn it off so the game runs better, now you can.
Or if you don't care about 60 frames per second, if that game runs
at that.
Or if
you don't care
about
60 frames. Like, if you're just going to record it anyway or whatever, I don't care if it's at 60 because my capture device only does 30. They still look the same on my screen and the capture device. But no, playing games in 60 is so fucking nice. But yeah, I like that. That's neat. I don't think this has ever been done before. That'd be cool if that became a thing. They mentioned chromatic aberration in the ability. I think they're going to basically anti-aliasing and some other shit. Anti-aliasing, if you play PC games, is one of those things, like, as you turn it up, it just fucking destroys your computer. So that could make a huge difference. Things might be a little jaggier, but whatevs. It'll run better.
Yeah.
And that's nice.
I have to say, like, so far, you know, as much as I rail on Ubisoft constantly, like, everything I hear coming out of these guys for this game, I'm starting to become mildly impressed.
Yeah, maybe
it actually pays off.
It's Ubisoft, but the developer is, you know, its own thing, right?
Give them time.
Have they made other games? Developers, massive. Red Storm Entertainment. Who's, like, the main? Do we know? Is it Red Storm? Is that the main one?
I don't know.
They made Far Cry 4, Ghost Recon, Future Soldier. Okay, so they make... Oh, well, they were involved with Far Cry 3 as well.
Yeah, Ubisoft Massive also worked on Far Cry 3. Assassin's Creed Revelations.
I don't know. There's like 50 studios working on it. So whatever. I like what I'm seeing out of this, though. I think after this weekend's beta, I'm probably going to pre-order it. I'm not doing any special editions or any of that bullshit.
I'm glad I learned my lesson over the beta, because I'm still wary enough that I would not buy it without being able to try it. But now I'll get to try it, and I might actually, you know, if I like it, then I'll be very excited, because I'll have a game I can play with people again. I miss that.
I miss you people. Hey, now you can just try to get, you know, a shift at some point where you're not getting home at, like, you know, the ass crack of dawn. That'd be fun, huh? You son of a bitch.
If you recall, I actually had finally managed to wing it so I could get off a little earlier on Tuesday.
And then everyone stopped playing Destiny. Yeah. What does that tell you,
Kyle? I can pick that back up. So
we're not going to play terrible games just to spend time with you.
Once, like, daylight savings shifts again, it'll actually mean something for you.
It will.
We'll be 2 hours different again.
Home earlier in my time. Woo!
Yep.
And let's see. Okay, and then we got some bad news. Oof. Man, a whole bunch of them. The Mad Cat CEO and board chairman have left the company, and they're laying off 37% of their employees. Jesus.
Yeah, the CEO and the board chairman left before the earnings report came out, and that's obviously not a good sign.
Yeah. So, earnings report comes out next week. In other news,
I gotta
the CEO
go.
Has quit. One day before the earnings report. Holy shit. And, you know, and it sucks because, you know, they ended up going over Rock Band, and it did well. It did pretty
not
good.
Well enough.
Just not as good as they wanted it to do.
Yeah.
But, I mean, fuck, it's expensive as fuck. Are they crazy? It's $250 fucking dollars for the band in a box. I'm sorry. That is fucking insane. I paid it because I had Best Buy's stupid 20% off thing. If I had that, I'd had some serious fucking reservations, especially considering the drums are kind of pieces of shit. A little bit. I cannot believe how much money they fucking charge for this, though. And it's like, yeah, what did you expect? How did you really seriously expect to sell tons of these things at $250 a piece? Like, holy shit. And then Guitar Hero Live is having a fucking fire sale since it came out. So, like, you guys are fucked. And the guitar bundle is like it's $20 more than Guitar Hero for no fucking reason.
Well, it's like, that's especially impressive because they haven't really changed anything with theirs, where Guitar Hero completely, like, changes the way it works.
I mean, I don't care for it, and what I've heard from it, I'm not going to play it. But it costs $20 less retail, in practice, $50 to $70. But yeah, they want the bundle, they want $120. Like, what the fuck is wrong with them? Like, why do they want so much? I don't get it. Why, like, why do they feel, oh, it's 130. Excuse me. Really?
Jesus.
130? Yeah. They just really the think their guitar bucks. Is worth $30 more than Guitar Hero Live. Like, I don't understand where they get these numbers from and how they don't think.
Well, actually, the guitar itself is $100, but then Guitar Hero Live with the new guitar is $100.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Like, they basically give you the game for free, comparatively.
Well, I think also the Guitar Hero Live controller was made a little more cheap. Not cheap, but shittily. Less quality. It's not terrible, but it's, I don't know. I feel like the Rock Band guitars were better.
Not great.
I never really liked the Guitar Hero, like, the guitars, the way they come apart like that. And it just, I don't know, it's that and just, I don't know, I never really felt good.
Guitar Hero guitars have totally felt like shit for a long time.
Yeah.
Also, I don't think they even sell the band in a box bundle for PS4 anymore. That's weird. I cannot find it. Online, it's sold out. The Xbox One ones are still there, I guess, because no one has one. Oh, wait, there it is. Okay, there it is. $250. Found it on Best Buy. It's still $250. They're out of their fucking mind. I thought they were lowering the price.
I know they put them on sale for $200 for a while, but
I guess they should have just fucking left it there. Jesus.
Yeah, that would be a better price.
It's two plastic instruments, a mic, and a game. $250 is crazy. The mic is like a $10 mic. That's not even worth mentioning. That's like a gimme. They just throw that in for free. There's no way you can tell me each of those instruments is worth $100 each. The guitar and the drums are both worth $100. No fucking way. And I think we've stumbled across why it's not selling as well as they'd hope.
Yeah.
No fucking way.
I don't know whether it's, I mean, yeah, it's been a while since they've released the game. This is a new, you know, system. That those are good things. But they also need to consider where the state of, you know, that kind of game was, too. It hasn't recovered that much. Like, Rock Band 3, when it came out, they dropped the price down to $20 within, like, a few months because they were pushing the DLC. Instead, they're like, here's the game cheap. Now let's get you hooked on our DLC, which is probably the right way to do it. You know, make the game cheap. Yeah. And definitely. Then really pump in, like, the music otherwise, which is somewhere they've failed, too. There's just not been a lot of, like, choice stuff since it came out.
They haven't had tons of DLC because, let's be honest, the game isn't done.
Not
they didn't finish. So that's why they're not even pumping out a lot of DLC.
I feel like themselves. What happened there is, you know, they announced they were doing it. Everybody's like, all right. And then Activision's like, hey.
We're going to shit something out real quick.
And they're like, fuck. Then it had to be a punch.
If you think about it, they kind of did have their hand forced because if they hadn't released,
yeah,
Guitar Hero might have cannibalized all their sales.
Yeah, like I get why they did it. It was just really annoying.
Yeah, it's knowing that it's not done.
They have like an actual schedule for getting some of the other stuff in, though, so that's good.
Sort of, yeah. A little loose schedule. It's good. Definitely.
I just need to work on their DLC a bit. I do not want to fucking play Justin Bieber and whatever the fuck else they stuck in there.
What in the fuck? Come on.
I think there must be some.
I want to see how many of those sold. I want numbers on the Biebs.
Like, I think There's no fucking way. DLC set I saw was like better songs, but still not songs I picture myself playing in Rock Band. Like they had a Daft Punk song. And then,
I don't get, like, how does that work in Rock Band, you know?
Well, the deaf one was...
You can't even sing a fucking...
The Daft Punk song Daft was Get Lucky, so it kind of makes sense for it.
Yeah, that one's okay, not so bad, though. Right.
Actually, I bought that. That's fun. I thought you were talking about something else. I was like, what, is it going to be like Around the World, and you're just going to say Around the World for fucking 10 minutes?
Well, the stuff that's coming out this week doesn't sound so bad. Five Finger Death Punch, Motorhead, and Royal Blood.
Oh, that's not so bad.
Five Finger Death Punch is great to listen to, but like Sevenfold, when it comes time to play it, fuck me raw.
What Five Finger Death Punch song?
Got Your Six. I don't know.
They're all the same. It's four bass pedals and 13 guitars. That's every Five Finger Death Punch song. There's no fucking way any of us are going to play those.
That Royal
Every
Blood
single
song.
Instrument's going to be devil horns, including the fucking singing.
That Royal Blood song is very good.
I've got the deepest voice, and I still don't think I could do it.
Actually, most of the songs like that, the vocals are like nothing, because it's all just...
He could carry a melody. Yeah, well, he can. Unbelievably deep voice.
He can, yes, but most stuff like that, that's just it's, growling.
Well, yeah, it's chug, 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 and... It's corn, basically. Yeah. But, yeah. It's one of those, yeah, fun to listen to. I don't know about playing it. Because I have, like, one Avenged Sevenfold song because it, like, came with one of the games. And I was like, yep, not getting any more
there's
of
only,
these.
There's only a couple of those that I couldn't play. Like, most of them I didn't think were that bad.
I think I have all of them. I'm not good at them, but I like playing them.
It's just, it's too much strumming. Too much weirdness. Is it Nightmare? Is that the one that came on one of the discs?
Possibly. I really liked playing that one.
Too much. No, it's not that one. The other one was had a weirder.
Hail to the King is what the song of theirs I can't play at all because it starts off with fucking weird ass.
Yeah, that one's pretty fucking hard.
That's the one that came on disc. Which one?
Hail to the King.
Yeah. Yes.
That one
yes.
was on 4.
That one's fucking impossible. Jesus Christ. Yeah, fuck that.
Yeah, some of the shit. Yeah, fucking like that Daft Punk song. That one I can see. That one works. But then
fun to sing too. At least if they're fun to sing.
Kelly
Any
Clarkson.
Other Daft Punk song? There's no vocals. It's
yeah.
It's someone repeating a quote 14 times.
That
like,
one
there's
I
nothing
get.
Happening.
And then like Outkast. Although I like
Hell
that
yeah.
song.
I got that one.
A couple Bruno Mars songs.
Fuck all the others, but they did put in Uptown Funk. I got that too.
Well, that one was on disc.
Oh, that's right. Yep. I got Get Lucky and yeah, the.
Hey, it's a fun. It's a fun song to play too. It's not really that hard, but like you can really like, enjoy it.
Everybody likes singing that song. I remember I heard that and I was like, you know, I'd heard of this Bruno Mars guy. If this is what he sounds like, and then I went and found someone, and I was like, oh, all right, never mind.
He's more R&B, but I think he's really good.
I don't like it.
You don't
Uptown
like
Funk
anything
one.
That's not fucking like corn.
Uptown Funk, the music isn't made by his usual people.
Yeah, I was
going to
say,
Ron,
so somebody else was
fuck.
Helping him.
Mark Ronson. One. I don't know who that is, but I just know his name because I played that song the other day.
Yeah, so that guy makes cool music and Bruno Mars can sing. Just what he usually sings is horribly, depressingly boring to me. So...
My thing is, though, there's just been like an extravagant amount of like pop shit thrown
yeah,
in here.
Yeah, I don't get it. Like, you
like
just made a
fucking
game for playing guitar and all the shit is like pop singing.
Like, they even had that L.A. King song on there, that X's and O's one I hear on the fucking pop station at work all the time.
I don't even know what that is.
It's a song.
Oh, well,
okay.
Thank you.
Thanks. Good thing you said that.
LA.
I would have thought it was an animal.
That just said L.A. Kings. I was
no,
like, the
LA
hockey
Kings.
Team has a fucking
yes.
theme song?
Well, a side note that I had to throw out there, because I found this out randomly the other day. She is actually Rob Schneider's daughter.
Rob Schneider. Rob Schneider's daughter is a
Look
singer.
What you've done. You've unleashed
but
the
she's
Schneider
about
offense.
To find out. Music's not as all it's cracked up to be. Rob Schneider's what? Daughter is the bass guitar. Rated PG-13.
So anyway, another actually less retarded than this conversation news.
Shut
but
up.
Sad. Game Trailers is shutting down. Now, it's sad. I don't get it, though. Because we were reading this, and it was like, they just got bought in 2014, and then almost immediately... They started doing layoffs, and now they're closing them. So why the fuck did they even buy them? If all they were going to do is buy it and shut it down, why would you waste the money?
Oh.
I don't understand what the company that bought them is getting out of this. Or why they bought them in the first place. Like, if it was just a money sink, like, then what the fuck would you buy them in the first place? Did you somehow not know how bad their financials were, and then you went, oh, shit, and just tried to start shedding weight? I don't get it. That's so weird.
Probably just wanted to be able to say they own the name.
Fucking who cares?
Yeah, it's not like Game Trailers has mattered for like 10 years.
Who the fuck even goes there?
They used to go there all the time.
We like, go like there 2 years ago. E3.
Well, no, like, once like upon a time, they were.
They had some retrospectives on games that were really interesting to listen to.
Yeah, well, I never
watch, rather.
Maybe I mean, not there by accident.
I haven't been there in a while. I'm not going to miss it, but they had some good stuff on there.
So, but that, you know, it's sad.
It's been around since 2002, news. For crying out loud.
What's that?
It's been around since 2002, so it lasted a long time.
But yeah, in happier news, Amazon is releasing a free game engine.
Yay.
Now, the only thing is, I have no idea what this looks like. I don't know if they've... Did they provide any, like, visuals for this game engine? Any, like, examples? I mean, I guess it's just an engine, but I don't know. But, hey, that's cool. It's always good to have free game engines available. It's interesting that Amazon's doing it. I wonder if they're going to start making their own games or anything like that.
They bought Double Helix. People that did the first season of the new Killer Instinct.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Huh. That's when Iron Galaxy took over for the second season of Killer Instinct stuff.
I see. Interesting. Oh, yeah. That's interesting.
Interested in checking it out. I doubt I'll ever do anything with it, but it'll be interesting to look at it, at least.
Well.
And then this other thing.
Kind of good news.
Kind of true, but not really. we're going to have to quantify this. There will be no new Assassin's Creed game this year. And by no new Assassin's Creed game, they mean no like mainline game that is, you know, one of the things currently running the franchise into the ground. They're still going to release like two other stupid shovelware versions of Assassin's Creed. I don't know, whatever the
one,
fuck they are.
One's a mobile game and two of them are no like
anchor.
Part two and three of like a three-part like mini, like, you know, all together it would have been one game, but they cut it up into pieces.
And it all sounds pointless. So
pretty much. That's like what, Assassin's Creed Chronicles or something like that, and each of the games is set in a different time period and country. Like one is in like Egypt or something like that.
And they're like side-scrolling games, I think. I remember seeing, I think, the one for China, but that was back around the time it came out.
The update, it actually provides some interesting insight. Maybe Ubisoft's trying to pull their head out of their ass. Explained that the break from Assassin's Creed during the company's earnings call today, the goal, he said, was to finish developing future games in the series earlier so that the company could spend more time polishing them. The point is to spend less money on that final polish, limiting the amount that needs to be done post-launch. Assassin's Creed Unity, for example, notably shipped with several issues,
which several the company putting it lightly.
Attempted to address after its debut. I like which the company attempted to address after its debut.
Unity was a clusterfuck.
So I guess that's kind of good to see them, like, I don't know why they had to fuck up this bad to understand what is a pretty basic part of making a fucking video game.
On top
which
of
is
that too,
to make sure that it's fucking finished before you release it.
Isn't the movie they're making supposed to be coming out this year or something?
Yeah, whatever. Yep. Who gives a shit? He might did mention cool. something about that. I don't know. It might be. Let's be honest, though. It hasn't happened yet. Like, video game movies, I'm just not going to get my hopes up. I'm trying right now to think of a game based on a movie that was based on a video game that was actually any good.
Super Mario Brothers.
While I enjoy the Resident Evil movies for the mindless stupidity that they are, I don't really think that I would count that because they have like only a fleeting resemblance to the source material.
I liked the first one, and that was about it.
I liked the first two. Like after that, it was like, what is this?
Second one, in the second one, they fucking ruined Nemesis for me.
Yeah, well, that's true.
You gotta look at them like they're just zombie movies. That's why I say I don't count it, even though I like them, because they're not really Resident Evil movies.
Well, if they had
they're movies about Mia Jovovich killing zombies and shit.
Well, yeah,
which is cool. I like Mia Jovovich, and I like killing zombies.
I really love the character of Nemesis in 3. That was one of my favorite Resident Evil games. So to see it kind of ruined was frustrating to me.
I like the Mortal Kombat movies. I always enjoyed those.
You mean the first one?
I wouldn't say movies.
Yeah, the first one. Yeah.
I don't know if you've watched the second one in a while, but holy shit, it's even worse than I remembered.
It was bad when it came out. It's worse now.
I didn't hate it, but...
No, you will if you watch it again.
That's probably true.
I'm not a picky person. I'll watch a lot of stuff. I just told you how I like the Resident Evil movies. Okay. Mortal Kombat Annihilation is one of the worst fucking movies I've ever seen.
Let's jam as much as we can in an hour and a half.
Yeah.
Oh, and let's kill out Johnny Cage in the first 5 minutes.
Fucking guy that plays Raiden with some fucking... Where the fuck did that guy even come from? The one they replaced him with? Was he getting coffee for someone? And they just fucking grabbed him and said, hey, you're Raiden.
Put on a white wig. Oh no, that dude was the guy who played Dexter's father in the series Dexter. Can't remember his name now.
God, it was, wasn't it?
But fucking Christopher Lambert in the first movie was fucking amazing as Raiden.
Yeah.
Yeah, they fucking replaced Christopher Lambert with some other asshat.
James something, I can't remember his name. But
there can be only one.
Also, what do we count as video game movies? Because Final Fantasy VII Advent Children was fucking amazing.
Oh, that was more like they just took... And made more it was CG.
Basically also, a sequel, kind of, yeah. But it also, wasn't an adaptation.
It also wasn't a Hollywood movie.
Oh no.
It was Square doing their own thing.
Yeah. Oh, well, no, that wasn't a video game. Never mind. That was a comic first.
Did I find the wrong Mortal Kombat Annihilation? Why can't I find Raiden? they spelled his name with a Y? What?
I think in some...
not crazy, right? That's not how his name is spelled.
No, but no. I think in the very first Mortal Kombat game, it was spelled that way for some reason. And then every game after that was fixed.
Oh, sometimes spelled Raiden. Oh, you.
It was probably because they figured James American audiences wouldn't be able to figure out how to pronounce Raiden correctly.
Oh, I know this guy from stuff.
Yeah, from Dexter, I just told you.
No, I've never watched Dexter, so... No, I do not know him from Dexter.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Well, I was going to start watching it, and then it apparently had the worst last season of any TV show ever. So
watch season one, watch season two, skip season three, and watch season four. Season four is absolutely incredible.
Which season was that?
The one with Trinity Killer.
Oh.
John Lithgow.
Yep, that was really good.
Back to our video games. Let's get through this other stuff real quick. I need to show... my lols about this. So,
oh boy, here we go. Buckle in, everybody.
We got a lot of stuff to say about this. Okay, so Quantum Break is coming to PC. Yay. Everyone is having a fucking hissy fit because fanboys make everything irritating. There's some guy on Twitter fucking just having an absolute fucking shit fest. And Phil Spencer replies to this guy because he's like, and sad to say, I canceled my Quantum Break pre-order. As I said, I would. You weren't up front on Quantum Break coming to PC. And Phil Spencer just replies, you canceled a pre-order for a game you want to play because someone else gets to play the game on Windows?
I knew I liked this guy for a reason.
Yeah, he fucking responded to that, a lot of that stuff like a champ.
And it's awesome because it's yeah, that's pretty much what I would say. Yeah. Dude, what is wrong with you? Did you forget to take your pills this morning?
Well, everybody else jumped in on that shit, too, because at one point he's, complaining because he bought an Xbox One, 4 months ago for this game. It's
I bought this for this game, and, well, you can still fucking play it!
Yeah. Well, everybody's wait, so you bought a console for a game that isn't even out yet? Good job.
What an asshole.
And then he started complaining.
Xbox owners.
At some point, too, he started bitching about, the fact that, PC players can play online games for free and you have to pay for Xbox Live. And everybody's like, this is a single player game. What does that have to do with anything?
What the fuck are you talking about? Oh, Christ. So that's retarded. Now, I do have one comment to make. And that is something that kind of slipped by unless you're a PC gamer. It's only being released on the Windows Store. And fuck that. Now, you guys may not be familiar with this, but Tomb Raider recently had a release on the Windows Store. And it was simultaneously released on there and on Steam. The Windows Store version is fucked. It is fucked. There's tons of options that don't work. The game will only run full screen windowed mode. You can't use like real full screen mode. You can't change any of it. You can't use overlays on the game from like other programs. You can't record the game. You can't do fucking anything. It's gimped as fuck because it uses some Windows, you know, universal app bullshit, which is just Microsoft being the assholes that we know them to be. So while I applaud them bringing it to PC, I do not applaud them bringing us a potentially broken, gimped piece of shit. Because if I wanted to play it like I play it on my console, I would just fucking play it there. When I get on my computer, you know, I want to use my fucking tools and fucking, you know, layovers. Or layover? No. Overlays.
Can't talk.
I'm not going to Dallas for a layover. But it's just, it's fucking annoying. Like, the reason people play on PC partly is the freedom to do whatever you want with the game. And them basically gimping it down again to like a fucking console game that runs on your computer is like super annoying. And there's even like options and shit that you can't turn on, and the game runs like ass on people that are using SLI, and it's just a fucking nightmare. So that sucks ass.
Now I'm sad again.
I know. Like they announced this, and then it's like, oh great.
Oh, because it's one of those games where, you know, they announced it. I was like, holy shit, this looks kind of fucking cool.
And now, this article like, you Xbox posted only. From Polygon about it is kind of retarded. I don't know where the fuck they're getting their specs from. Okay, they recommend a GeForce 980 Ti video card. That's their recommended specs. And I'm like, what in the fuck is in this game? Like, there's no way that the fucking Xbox is running anything close to what they're recommending here, or even the minimum requirements. The minimum requirements would eat an Xbox One alive. If you look at these things, it's the minimum requirements is an i5 4460 2.7 gigahertz chip and a GTX 760, which is like two Xboxes. So that's like hilarious. And so I was just looking at this Polygon article and getting like super irritated because they're like, PC players don't pay less because they recommend a $600 video card. And I'm like, and now I'm not liking Polygon anymore. This is that guy Ben Kuchera too. That was the one that did the Penny Arcade stuff. He needs to stop saying things that are stupid. But anyway,
Like that whole thing though, like, you know, I saw this whole everything about the game. And I was like, this seems, oh, it's Xbox. Oh well. And then they announced this, you know, and I was like, yes, I can actually, and, you know, I just built a new computer. I could totally realistically play this. And then you tell me about the Windows Store thing, and I'm just like, no.
Yeah, it's definitely do not pre-order.
Unless somebody like cracks the shit out of it.
You absolutely must. No, cracking it won't do shit. It's still a Windows Universal app.
Oh.
Wait until it releases and we'll see how limited it really is.
But yeah.
I would not recommend buying it in the state that the Tomb Raider is in currently on the Windows Store. If it releases like Tomb Raider, just don't do it.
Maybe they'll learn something from Tomb Raider. Maybe.
No, they won't. Do you think they give a fuck, honestly? I'm serious.
I don't.
Microsoft does not care. They don't want you to use stuff outside their little ecosystem.
I was so excited to actually be able to play this
game. They will take worse sales and not fucking care. They don't have to. Like, they want you to use their shit, and if you don't, fuck you.
Seriously, like one of those things too, where I got all excited. I started watching like gameplay videos and stuff. I was like, this is going to be so fun.
Yay!
Ruined my life.
Oh, I don't know. We'll see. Maybe it turns out it's not as bad. I'm just saying, do not pre-order.
I wasn't going to pre-order.
Anyone, all of the three people that listen to this, don't do it.
No intention of pre-ordering, at least.
But, in general, pre-ordering is a little silly, but whatever. I like getting free stuff for pre-ordering. Although this game doesn't really come with anything anyway, so who gives a shit? No. In the grand scheme of things, most pre-order bonuses are fucking useless. Except the one for Borderlands 2. It came with a fucking character. That was annoying. Anyway. So another shitty news. Activision's gonna have some layoffs. Most basically due to weak Guitar Hero sales. Shocker. And Skylanders performance. I thought that thing was like a money printing machine for them.
Well, it was, but then they started releasing one every fucking year with like crazier shit. Like the last one that came out, I saw a thing for it at the store and I was like, what the fuck are they doing? It's like vehicle based. So they have these giant fucking vehicles you have to buy for it. Basically, like they've taken it, you know, they crossed that line like they like to do.
So wait, you're telling me Activision released a game year after year after year?
And I am shocked.
Truly. Which, you know, at that point, it's one thing to do that, but then to do that and expect you to buy like $15, like dozens of $15 toys every time too? Nah. People finally got fed up.
Good. I find that whole fucking thing just retarded. I would never, if I had kids, I would never let them even look at that because it's just a fucking money-making scheme. It's the most shameless money-making scheme I've ever fucking seen. It's worse, like way worse than the Amiibos, which are modeled after it.
Well, like the, yeah, well, the Amiibo thing is a better form of that because, you know, they work with multiple games.
Uh-huh.
It's not just, hey, like, here's a Pokemon game. Only these Pokemon ones work with it. Look, there's 150 of them. Or whatever. There's like 500 Pokemon now, but you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm. There's like last count like 487 or something ridiculous.
When you say many.
I disagree.
When you say a dramatic number like 500, you're actually pretty fucking close.
I disagree. There are still only 150 Pokemon. You will never convince me otherwise.
Excuse me, there's 151, idiot.
Okay, fine. Yeah. I'll give you that.
God. What's wrong with you?
Fucking noob.
Speaking of which, I saw GameStop was giving out Mew.
Dear sweet Jesus. There are 721 Pokemon.
What?
How is
you
that
a liar.
Awesome? No way.
Wish you weren't a liar.
Oh my god. How? Why? Holy shit. That's fucking crazy, dude. I'll link everyone to this. 721. There's a Pokemon number 720 is called Hoopa. Yes. That is what I just said. Hoopa.
Is it shaped like a hoop? Is.
It does have hoops. On its horns. A bad thing has happened. Anyway. Oh, and another bad thing happened.
I imagine at least 10 of them are like insanely similar to Pikachu, too.
Oh, I'm sure there's at least 47 different kinds of mice.
It's Pikachu.
Well, I was playing that game that I was talking Pac-Man. About the last episode. Like, I caught like these two. They look like Pichu, only one is like, instead of the black coloring, like it's yellow and red and has like a minus sign on it on its cheeks. And the other one is blue and yellow and has a positive sign on its cheeks. And it's like, are you fucking serious?
They go together, bro.
Someone's running out of ideas.
Running? They've been out of ideas since the first... They've been out of ideas before they finished the first 150.
One.
That horse has been beaten so hard, it's like bones are made of powder now.
Yeah. It's been made into glue and used for children's construction paper. Yeah. Anyway, so the last thing...
In this monster podcast.
God, this is going to be a long one.
I might not have enough video footage for this one now. Jesus Christ.
Actually, okay. It's kind of a bad but potentially good thing. The lead writer for Mass Effect Andromeda is leaving BioWare. Fuck. But he's joining Bungie.
Yay! Hey. Potentially.
So that sucks for Mass Effect because... is that the guy that left and came back again and he's leaving again? Or no. Is this someone different?
Yeah, someone else.
Okay. It sucks, though. Sucks for BioWare. But that's fine. Maybe Destiny 2 will, you know, have a story. So that kind of sucks and is good at the same time. Like I said. What are you going to do?
Wait. Did this guy even do anything at BioWare?
Oh.
Like, from the sound of it, like, he started at BioWare, like, literally, and, like, probably started there to work on this game and is now leaving it before the game's even fucking finished. Because before that, he worked at 343 and, like,
oh, wrote... that's funny. The guy that came before him came from Bungie.
It's like a goddamn juggling act.
Yeah, he was the senior writer for Halo 4.
No, not the guy before. This is the guy. Chris Schlurf? I don't know what the fuck kind of...
This guy wrote Halo 4, Destiny 2 is fucked.
Worked on Halo 4? Oh, God. Never mind.
He was maybe this is a good thing. Halo 4.
It's the opposite of what we thought. It's a good thing for BioWare and a bad thing for Bungie.
It's a good thing for everybody. Except Bungie.
Yeah, he left 343 in 2013, like late 2013. I went to BioWare specifically to work on Mass Effect Andromeda, it sounds like, and then is now left before that game's even done.
Maybe he already finished writing all of it. Yeah,
finished writing and was like, peace out. I'm going back to write more terrible stories for Bungie. Lol, lol, lol. Oh, wait. Well, it was 343 before, but whatever.
Same
difference. 343, the company Microsoft formed of fucking previous Bungie people. Whose sole existence is to make Halo. So yeah, that about does it. I have not played any games this week. I did play some Smash Brothers, I guess.
Oh, yeah. It's been long enough since we recorded this. You guys could probably talk about Division.
Oh yeah, yeah. We were supposed to actually do that, but then
I don't remember anything about Division.
You got the video, right?
Some of it. For some reason, my
wow, it really has been that long, huh?
Reason my recording software decided to stop recording about 21 minutes in.
That's fun. I have a video that's like, you know, an hour and a half or so.
Put that up and send it to me.
I did.
All right, then. Carry on. Oh.
The end.
I suppose it's not a terrible thing, then, since we'll probably be talking about it next week or next time.
We will.
Next week.
Well, I mean, I get into it.
I'll actually be able to. Did you have fun?
It was fun. Yeah.
It was all right.
All right.
The shooting is less than ideal.
Some of the guys are kind of bullet spongy as well.
Yeah. Not hugely into that.
But it felt a lot more tactical than like Destiny did, which is kind of nice.
It definitely had more tactics to it. I wasn't huge on the shooting. It's a third-person shooter, so it's got third-person shooter controls, you know?
Yeah.
It's not an FPS. The shooting just feels a little loose.
There really wasn't a whole lot. It's a little
stiff. I did
the game either.
In contrast to Destiny, that if I run,
when
I stop running, if I want to run again, I don't have to wait an arbitrary amount of time to run again.
And you can reload while running.
Yes.
Oh, shit.
Game changer.
It is. Me and Nick played a bunch together. I played through, you know, all the way through the little, like, one mission, and I got my one upgrade, and, you know, because you get little bombs you can throw down that heal everyone around you, so those are cool.
Oh, yeah.
The
one thing I do remember about that game that really pissed me off is there are guys that charge at you with, like, baseball bats, and you can shoot them with the shotgun, but they don't slow down.
Yeah.
They just keep fucking coming at you. That's really annoying.
I really hope that they fix that, because that's fucking ridiculous. Yeah, dude will run at you with a bat. You'll shoot him, like, a lot.
And they don't flinch.
And he'll keep running. No flinching.
You mean you don't keep running when you get shot with a shotgun?
Yeah, pussy. I know. I'm such a puss. So that I did not enjoy. That seemed to happen a little more on hard. It's one of those things that developers like to do, where they think that hard means be really fucking cheap, and that's not what hard is. Hard is use better tactics, not run through shotgun fire. That's not using better tactics. That's actually the opposite of using better tactics if you're being hit by the shotgun in the first place.
Yeah.
So that was irritating. But overall, I mean, I really did like it. You know, the group stuff, it's really easy to jump in a group together and you go take on a mission. And there's a normal version and a hard version, and you know, it all flows pretty good. The story, you know, relatively non-existent for most of the beta because there's not a lot of story in the beta.
There was a story mission and that was it.
So it's kind of hard to say what that's going to be like. I think the game started with some sort of video, but it didn't give us a whole lot of information. Basically, you know, shit's fucked up. Everyone is fending for themselves. So
something really bad happened around on Black Friday that turned the world into what it is now.
Yeah.
That's all I really remember.
It would be Black Friday.
The blackest of Fridays.
Blacker Friday.
So that, you know.
I like the, the blackest black times infinity.
The loot isn't super annoying. It was just, you know, you got a good amount of loot while you're doing stuff, so you got a little bit of upgrades here and there. Your typical loot game. Not like, you know, whatever. There's nothing. We'll see what that all goes. It sucks because now I got to relearn a whole bunch of stats and what the fuck they do again. It's like my least favorite part of these games is relearning all that shit.
It should be fine as long as they don't come up with like weird ass fucking words for, you know, normal stats. Oh, did they?
What half of it means. Not weird words. I don't know what the stats mean. Like, I don't know what they do. I think sometimes they increase your health. Sometimes they increase your DPS. Which I don't get why those are like extra stats, because like you'll have more armor but your health won't go up, I guess. I don't know. I gotta learn it. Just more, you know, it's an RPG, so you gotta do all that shit.
Oh, like, because that's just
no light level, so
most games will have like, okay, strength, intellect, agility type thing, but then you get some games it's like, well, here's a stat, it's called alacrity or mastery. It's like, what the fuck does that even mean?
No,
yeah. Strength, intellect, agility, stamina.
No. STR, int, stam. God damn it.
5 stam, 5 int, leather belt.
So, overall, though, it was fun. It's not perfect, but I'm going to play it. I'm going to buy it, probably. I'm waiting for that open beta just to see. It'll be more fun with more people to play with.
From the sound of it, it was like a legit beta and not a look at our shiny product beta. So, like, yeah. It sounds like they're legitimately trying to fix
the stuff.
It's a
little rough around the edges, that's for sure. There's definitely some things they need to adjust. I really hope that they reconsider the bullet spongy nature of some of those enemies, because it's not fun to fire that much into an enemy. You know?
5 minutes.
That's one of the
bullets.
Things that was really annoying about Destiny bosses. It was just a big dude that stands there and you fire a million bullets. And that wasn't just Rocket McDickface. That was like half the bosses in the game. So I really hope they avoid that. I will say, fucking, oh my god. MT, we got to remember to link to this in the article about the podcast. I have the most fucking awesomest shit ever that I put on YouTube. It's in the topic, too. You can shoot. There's these guys that have tanks on their backs. They have like a, what do you call it, a flamethrower. If you shoot it enough times the right way, they'll start setting on fire and fucking explode.
Yeah, watch that video. Like, and then some of like the other enemies will actually see it and run away from them.
They do. And I was like, whoa, that's awesome. The other enemies,
cool.
At one point, someone goes, oh, fuck, and jumps out of the way. I was like, what? It was awesome. It was either oh, fuck, or oh, shit. It was probably oh, shit, but whatever. He cursed, because that's what someone does when they're about to blow up.
He said naughty words.
He said naughty words. 3 edgy, 5 me. That was cool. I liked it. I had a lot of fun with that part.
It's a nice touch.
Just one of these missions you go to do, or it was just a random thing I ran across, because there's lots of just little shit happening that you can run into. It shows up on your map. You run over there and it's just these dudes with fucking flamethrowers robbing something, and I was like, oh my god. You know, the first one, I'm like, what the fuck just happened? This is awesome. And so from that point forward, you know, Nick got like 2 kills. Because I spent the rest of the time blowing everyone up because it was fucking awesome. It'd be like, boop, 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 boop. And you know, they get hit and they're like, oh no. So it was fucking awesome. definitely looking forward to the open beta. We can definitely, get maybe a group of four together and just really, you know, run through it.
Well,
apparently there'll be one more, I think, mission, and that will grant you one more upgrade too. So that's cool. I think it's like a turret or something. So, yeah, I'm liking what I see so far, and I'm looking forward to it. I guess that about does it for this week, then, huh?
I just hope it has enough stuff to keep people playing for longer than a couple
weeks. Yeah, that's the only thing I'm worried about.
Yeah. I haven't really played much this week. I ended up trying out Star Wars The Old Republic again, because my girlfriend played through both of the Knights of the Old Republic games and decided to jump on that again, since he actually understood some of the story now. This is the first time I've tried it since they went free-to-play. Because I saw their free-to-play model and was like, nope. And I have to say, they have improved it quite a bit. Like, if you want to just go in and play through the story, it's like set up perfectly for that now. You can actually turn off the indicator for the superfluous bullshit quests that nobody cares about and actually level through it fully just off of the story, like the main story quests, which is nice. But their free-to-play model is still really fucking asshole-ish. Really asshole-ish, so it's a little obnoxious that way, but I mean, I was impressed with what they've done with it overall. I don't know that I'm going to keep playing it. I'll probably just go through like one character story thing and stop again, but I have to say that their customer service has gotten better, though, because I actually had to call them to get my account going again, because I had one of those
authenticators.
Yeah, I had it on my old phone and I never deactivated it.
Whoops.
Yeah, so I had to call them to get that reset so I could put it on my new phone. And I called them at 3 in the morning and they answered it. My call got picked up in 10 seconds.
What the fuck?
Yeah, I figured they'd be closed, but I mean, obviously they're outsourced to India, but I didn't have that much trouble understanding her. And she helped me. It took 2 minutes to get it all fixed up. You know, they just verified my identity and I'm like, okay, it's all set. I'm like, cool.
Okay, bye.
Interesting. One thing that was nice, though, is apparently their currency that you have to pay money to get that gives you special shit in the game. Like, they give you a little bit each month if you have the security token active, and it counted mine as being active for 4 fucking years. So I've just had this giant amount of the currency, so I was able to buy most of the shit that they cut out of the game for the free to play version.
I hate you.
So that was nice.
You're a bastard.
But, yeah, I mean, it's all right. You know, if you like Star Wars, it's Star Wars. Although they've apparently got really fucking crazy with the lightsaber colors while I was gone. There is some there's dual colored ones now.
And you can have polka dot.
Not quite that bad, but there's one that's like pink and magenta, like lightsaber. And
but
there's one too. It's yellow and blue, and the inner the core of it is blue and the outside's yellow, and it looks like a fucking foam sword or something, because it's so ridiculous looking.
Sounds like fun.
But yeah, there's still a lot of negative things to it if you care about playing it past the story. But for just the story, it's worthwhile. I mean, it's completely free now, so there's that. That's I guess.
Cool. All right. Well, I think that's about
far more than enough.
Yeah. So shut the hell up, Kyle.
you guys don't have to edit this fucking thing, man.
You're welcome, MD.
Enjoy.
This is what happens when we wait too goddamn long between podcasts.
This is what happens when there's actual news. Yeah. What the fuck happened?
God.
Everything. So.
I mean, it's good, but.
We're going to draw this to a close now.
And, I could tell you what I'm playing, but I don't feel like it right now. I want this to be over with.
Make this end, please.
I'll just say I started playing Wolfenstein The Old Blood again, because I started it and just never finished it, so I'm kind of rushing through that. I'm doing cheats and everything, because I just kind of want to play, just to have something to play. Playing a little Smash Brothers here and there. We actually had a tournament going, which I'm already out of, because I'm terrible at the game. But, I've been playing a little more of that. That's fun again. Street Fighter V came out while we were recording this officially, so I hear as of right now it's the kind of a clusterfuck with the online servers and whatnot, so I'm kind of going to wait until at least tomorrow to play before I get into it, because like they have this currency called fight money that you can earn while playing the single player stuff, but if you get disconnected during some of it, like you don't get that money, or like if you're not connected while you're playing the story mode, you don't get the fight money from it. So I'm just going to wait for it to happen to calm down a little bit before I get into it.
Sounds really irritating.
Yeah, it's ridiculous because they beta tested the shit out of that game. They had 4 different beta tests, I think, but when it was all said and done, it's still fucked up. I played a game called Firewatch, which it's kind of hard to explain. If you know anything about the game Gone Home, it's kind of a game like that where it's not really much of like, it's more of an interactive story than it is an actual game.
Walking simulator.
Basically. it tells an interesting story. It's, I believe currently it's $20 on Steam and PS4. I think those are the only systems it's out on at the moment. It's worth playing. I don't know if it's worth $20. I enjoyed it. I finished it in like 3 hours, so it's not a long game by any means, but it told an interesting story.
I want to play it.
Yeah,
it's my kind of game.
It's worth checking out. I would maybe wait for it to be on sale for like $15 or $10 or something like that, but it's you know, it's worth playing. It's just not worth $20 right now. Yeah, that's basically it. I would get into more detail, but as I said, I'm fucking tired and I want this to be over with.
Alrighty. Well, let's just draw this down. There's your, you know, Facebook, Twitter.
Oh, we have an Instagram now. Not for this
for the
podcast
center.
Specifically, but for the Center Network.
Yep.
Which is Center Network, I believe, on Instagram.
Yes.
So check that out if you're into that sort of thing.
You know, we do these podcasts a lot, but, you know, if you ever want to chat with us, or chances are if you're listening to this, you are listening to it because you know us.
Hi, Des.
But if you haven't already, join the forum, thecenternetwork.com/forum.
We would love to have you. Even though we might seem insular, we're also actually a really nice group of people.
And, yeah, feel free to drop by the Facebook, Does This Game Suck, and
the Center Network.
Twitter that we update sparingly.
Twitter is Does Game Suck.
Yes. Yes, it is. So, until next week, or until next time.
Same bad time.
Goodbye. Thank you for joining us, Kyle.
Yep.
And thank you for joining us, MT.
Like you said goodbye before you said goodbye to us.
Yep. Fuck
asshole.
You guys. I'm out.
Drop the mic and walk away.
Okay, bye.